You have a splendid appearance and quite a remarkable head, though it is so little. You should do what you can to grow. Of course, it is not everyone that can have sealing wax dropped upon her. And the darning needle drew herself up so proudly that she fell out of the neckerchief into the sink, where the cook was at the moment rinsing. Now I'm going to travel, said the darning needle. If only I don't get lost. But that was just what happened to her. I'm too delicate for this world, she said as she found herself in the gutter. But I know who I am, and there is always some little pleasure in that. It was thus that the darning needle kept up her proud bearing and lost none of her good humor. And now all sorts of things swam over her, chips and straws and scraps of old newspapers. Only see how they sail along, said the darning needle to herself. They little know what is under them, though it is I, and I sit firmly here. See? There goes a chip. It thinks of nothing in the world but itself, of nothing in the world but a chip. There flows a straw. See how it turns and twirls about. Do think of something besides yourself, or you may easily run against a stone. There swims a bit of newspaper. That's written upon it is forgotten long ago. Yet how it spreads itself out and gives itself airs. I sit patiently and quietly here. I know what I am, and I shall remain the same always. One day there lay something beside her that glittered splendidly. She thought it must be a diamond, but it was really only a bit of broken glass from a bottle. As it shone so brightly, the darning needle spoke to it, introducing herself as a breastpin. You are a diamond, I suppose, she said. Why, yes, something of the sort.